Okay, today I want to go back and review something that we've talked about quite a number of times, but I think it's really important if you're interested in training your own dog by yourself. Now, you know, that doesn't mean you can't train with other people, but a lot of times you just want to be alone, but you still want to accomplish something. And that involves what we call going back to home plate. There's a crate, a half of a crate, preferably the bottom half, preferably a light colored one that can be seen. The object is the dog sits in the crate, you throw a mark, and the dog goes after it and comes to you. So you're not moving around. You're just in one spot. You send the dog back to the crate, and then you can go and do a different mark. The other thing you can do is put the dog in the crate, drive out or walk out, throw a mark, and you can go all the way back to where the dog is and send it. So essentially, you are doing all of the components of an actual mark by yourself without any helpers, throwers, gunners, any of that stuff. You can even get to the point where you're shooting flyers, the dog is in the crate watching, etc., etc. Now, a lot of people say, oh, I do that, I use a place board. A place board is fine, except you can't see it from a very long distance. And it's harder to get started because every dog knows what a crate is. They've gone, they probably have their dinner in them every night. They're used to the word kennel. And it's a different command that than normally is used in training. So when you say kennel, it's, oh, kennel, that means I got to go back to home plate and sit there and I'm going to get a mark. Most dogs, after a while, they get so excited when they even see a crate. I know that I've had dogs in seminars, for instance, where I've had somebody drag a crate 150 yards or 200 yards away. And if the dog can see the crate, you say, kennel, and whang, the dog goes. And now you've got a dog sitting out there and you can make a huge, beautiful mark and you don't need a soul. And you can do an enormous amount of training with this concept. So today's video is about that. And I've got Gabby here and she has just learned how to do this. So it's sort of a beginning lesson in going back to home plate. Okay, so here's the first baby step. They know how to go back to home plate with the kennel command. So here's the beginning stage of it. Gabby, come here. Ready? Kennel. Good girl, okay. So now just to begin with, just a little simple single off this way. Ready? I always holler sit before I throw. Ready? Sit. Back. Okay, good. That a girl, good. Heel. Sit. Good girl. Very good. Okay. Sit. So let's say you're just trying to exercise your dog. You can go to the park, and once this concept is learned, you can stand in one spot and give your dog all of the exercise that you want. Or if you're interested in competition, you can use it to begin very, very serious training. So I'll throw another. You can move. Come here, Gab. Ready? Ready? Sit. Ready? Kennel. Good girl. Okay, here's a longer one. Sit. Back. Okay. Good. Heel. Sit. Out. Sit. Okay, now you can make a watermark out of it if you choose. Here. Sit. Kennel. Sit. Back. Good girl. Okay. There you go. Heel. So a couple of other thoughts. You know, another advantage of a crate over a place board is a crate contains the dog. They start to feel that they're in a spot that they belong in. Plus, you can tell if they move out of it. So if you have a dog, for instance, that might creep, then if it's a place board, they can have their feet on the ground, and you could, if you're off in the distance, you can't tell whether they're on it or off of it. A crate, they're contained in it. So there's a big advantage, especially for puppies. Once they're big dogs and you know their capabilities, you know they're steady, you know they're not going to move, then you can eliminate it and just put a marker of some sort. So there's and plus it's just fun. It's fun for you, it's fun for the dog. I've been in places where people have gathered to watch this, where the crate is 100 yards away and the dog is sprinting to the crate and it gets in there and you throw a mark and it chases the mark, gets it, brings it to you, runs back to the crate. It's an exciting thing for everybody. So, kennel. Sit. Back. Okay. Good girl. Heel. Sit. You know, another thing just occurred to me. You can, here, sit. Sit. You can begin even to teach casting. Kennel. Good. Good girl. Okay, sit. Back. All right. Heel. Sit. Out. Sit. Okay, so that's the lesson on going back to home plate. The other thing you can do is you can even do complicated marks. As an example, you could do a big down the shore mark. And be out there, the dog is back in the home plate. You can send the dog, it can go out there, and if it doesn't make the mark correctly, you can even handle from that position. There's countless uses of this concept that you will dream up on your own as you get more and more involved in it. It's just an amazing tool. So if you have an older dog that you want to just exercise, it's great. If you want to have a way to train a dog for competition without requiring a lot of people, it's great for that. and you can use it to teach concepts because you can start to get them going and coming in the same direction. So I think that everybody should consider teaching your dog the kennel command. Now hang on a little longer, I have one more message coming up.
The voice of the Lord is over the waters. The God of glory thunders. The Lord is over many waters. The voice of the Lord is powerful. The voice of the Lord is full of majesty.